Hello guys, Unreal Academy here, and in today's video I will be showing you the controls of the mod. So if you get stuck in a specific part, you can refer to this video how to install the mod. To install the mod, just run the installer. It might give you an error that this is an unrecognized execution file. You can safely ignore that warning because I have not signed the app, so you can ignore the warning. Click next and browse to your Half-Life directory. So in my case, it's this directory right here, so I'm just going to paste it here and hit browse. Half-Life Alyx game, select the game folder and select OK, next, and it create these according to what you want. Wait for the mod to install. It will automatically create the backups, so you do not have to worry. You can refer to this README if you want in the future. It's also available in your game directory, this README. So if you have any questions regarding the mod, you can refer to this, as well as the FAQ post that I will link to in the comment and the description as well. Hit next and launch Half-Life Alyx. How to change the resolution. So if your resolution is not 1080p, what you can do is go to the desktop, right click on the Half-Life Alyx shortcut, click properties, and in the target field you will see -1080. Change this to your resolution. So if your resolution is 1440 pixels, change it to this. If your resolution is 4K, just change it to 2160. If your resolution is something that is not common, such as 1366768 or 1440900 pixels, then what you can do is type in minus W your resolution, so 1366, and minus H your height, which is 768. Hit OK, continue, and now if I were to launch this mod, you'll see run in 1366 resolution. So this is how you change the resolution of the mod. How to change controls. So if you want to change your controls, browse to your game directory, go to game, Half-Life VR, and open up the CFG folder, and in it open up the auto execute file, and you can change every aspect of the mod here. How to select the main menu options. In order to select the main menu options, press the mouse 4 button, and now in order to select the options, just look at them and then press the E key. If you cannot figure out where your cursor is, press the mouse 3 button to zoom in and make selecting much more easier for you. What to do after every level load. So after a new level loads, you're going to have to press T to enable the fake VR mode. If you do not press T, you will not be able to adjust your height. How to save, load, and quit the game. If you want to save a game, just press the F1 key on your keyboard, and it will automatically save the game. And in order to load the game, what you're going to have to do is press the F3 key on your keyboard. So if I were to press F3, the game that I previously saved will start to load. And now, as you can see, we are back right at where we saved the game. If you die in the game, then just press the F5 button to reload the last checkpoint of the game. So if I were to go here and get choked to death, now the game will say paused and I will not be able to move around. So if I just press the F5 button on the keyboard, the game will automatically reload from the last checkpoint. As you can see, the game is now starting to reload from the last checkpoint, which in our case is this point right here. If you want to quit the game, press F7 on your keyboard and the game will automatically quit. So as you can see, the game just quitted. How to enter height adjustment mode? In order to enter height adjustment mode, press the mouse 4 key and then press the space key to increase your height, and then press the mouse 4 button again to exit height adjustment mode, and your new height will be the height that you chose while in height adjustment mode. To decrease the height, keep pressing the mouse 4 button again and again and it will automatically decrease. How to know which hand is active? So if you want to know which hand is active, what you're going to want to do is right click anywhere, and if you can teleport, that means your left hand is active. If you can't teleport and the weapon selection wheel opens up, that means your right hand is active. How to switch between hands? If you want to switch between hands, just press the tab key on your keyboard and you will be able to switch between your hands. So right now I'm in teleportation. My left hand is active. And now if I press tab, my right hand becomes active. How to move around? In order to move around, you're going to have to switch to your left hand and then just press the right mouse button, and wherever you want to teleport, point over there and then release the right mouse button and you will get teleported over there. How to switch weapons? If you want to switch your weapons, switch to your right hand and then just press the right mouse button and keep it pressed and move your head left, right, or up and down to change your weapon. So up for the Glock, left for the shotgun, and the right for the SMG, and down for the multi-tool. How to move hand forward and backward? If you want to move your hand forward, press the 2 key on your keyboard and then scroll up to increase the hand distance or to move the hand forward, and scroll down to move the hand backwards. Press 2 again to switch to right hand and scroll up to move the hand forward, scroll down to move the hand backwards. How to control hand rotations? If you want to rotate your hand, press 3 on the keyboard and now you should be able to rotate your hand. So 3 is for the X axis rotation, 4 is for the Y axis rotation, and 5 is for the Z axis rotation. How to pick up things using both hands? So if you want to be able to pick up the thing using both hands, press shift and then press the left mouse button and both hands will now pick the thing up. How to store things and access things in your wrist pocket? In order to store things in your wrist pocket, switch to the left hand and grab whatever it is you want to store in the wrist pocket by pressing the left mouse button and then pressing the F button on the keyboard and then leaving the left mouse button, and the thing will automatically get stored in your wrist pocket. To take things out of the wrist pocket, press F again and press the left mouse button, leave F button, and you will have the thing in your hand. How to use syringe? If you want to use the syringe, switch to your left hand, press the left mouse button and to take the syringe, and now press the middle mouse button and press the F button, and you just use the health pen or the syringe. How to store and take out items from your backpack? If you want to store items inside your backpack, switch to your left hand, grab the item you want to store, press the 1 key and leave the left mouse button, and it will automatically get stored in the backpack. So let me try that again with the recent. Grab it using my left hand, press the 1 key and leave it, and it will automatically get put in my backpack. If I want to take it out, I do the same thing. So switch to my left hand, press the one key and then press the left mouse button and it will automatically come in my hand. So let me try that again. Press the one button, press the left mouse button, and as you can see, I now have the ammo in my hand. How to throw items. If you want to throw an item, such as a grenade, just look at the item, pick it up, press the middle mouse button, and then throw it using this technique. So if you want to see that again, press the middle mouse button to detonate it, and to throw forward, just make this movement with your hands or mouse and it will get thrown forward. How to reload the gun when Russell gives you the ammo. So if you want to reload the gun when Russell gives you the ammo, and since you have infinite ammo, you can just break the lock using the gun by firing at the lock, and now the next sequence will fire and you will be able to progress forward. Please make sure you do not noclip to the next area, because otherwise the level trigger will not fire. How to put on the Russell headset. In order to put on the Russell headset, come closer to the headset, grab it using your right or left hand, and when you have grabbed it, press the 2 key on your keyboard to enable the hand editing mode. So first, when you press the 2 key, it will move your left hand. You will be able to move your left hand. And if you press the 2 key again, you will be able to use the right hand. Now, since I'm holding the headset with my right hand, I'm going to press 2 again to enable right hand editing mode. And now scroll down to bring the headset closer to your head, and once it is as near like once it appears like this, just leave it and it will automatically get put on your head. How to use the weapon upgrader or the combine fabricator. In order to use the combine fabricator to upgrade your weapon, first solve the puzzle. Once the puzzle has been solved, go near the combine fabricator and put your gun inside the combine fabricator. And then to select the options, press the mouse 4 button to enable height adjustment mode. And then you can select your option using the E key. So if I want to add the reflex sight, I'm going to press E while aiming at it, and it will ask me to insert the resin. So I'm going to exit height adjustment mode by pressing the mouse 4 button. And now make sure you switch to your left hand. Once your left hand is activated, make sure you're not aiming at this screen. Press the 1 button and then press the left mouse button and the resin will automatically come into your hand. So look to the side, press 1, press the left mouse button, and the resin will automatically come in your hand.